Rice is has a taste of onions, of course, caramelized onions, because I put the caramelized onions in oil as the base for the fried rice. When the fried rice touches the tomato sauce, which was on top of the egg, it kind of makes it, elevates the deliciousness of the fried rice. Without the tomato sauce, I can taste the sweetness of the dark soy sauce which I put in just now. Let's eat this with some of the egg. You can call this the open pattaya fried rice. You know, in Malaysia, the Malays that sells food by the roadside stalls back in 2000 and yeah, the year 2000, early 2000s to 2004, they were having like this pattaya fried rice. It's a rice inside a egg. So this is something like that. It's like a open egg, you know. Open egg. The rice is open to the atmosphere and not covered by an egg. So egg and rice. Egg is always wonderful with rice, especially fried rice. With the tomato sauce thrown in it, you'll definitely be better, because tomato sauce is basically made out of hopefully tomato and also a lot of sugar. Sugar plays a very important role in the body, and once we taste sugar in our receptors, like the teeth, like the tongue, it immediately sends a signal to the brain, and I think it's endorphins, you know, the hormone, is it a hormone? Chemicals called endorphins. So it tells you, it's just like having orgasm or sex. It's good. Eat more of it. Do more of that. That's the good, feel good feeling. Good feeling, yeah. The good feeling of having sugar in your food. That's why most sauces, you always eat your things with sauces, like barbecue sauce with your barbecue ribs and stuff. By its own, barbecue ribs is very delicious, of course. What isn't? And especially when it's made up from pork. But once you put the sauce on it, which is normally sugar, which has been caramelized, if you cook the sauce or you barbecue the sauce with the ribs, sugar is everywhere. Makes food taste better and can be quite... it sweetens your food and makes it taste better, but do you need more sugar in your life? Fruits already come with sugar, right? Natural sugars. Fruits is good for health, so it's natural sugar and it's good. But do we need refined white sugar or sugar put into all these products like sweet, dark, soy sauce, tomato sauce and everything else? Of course, when it comes to say tomato sauce, if it's not made with sugar, then it's not tomato sauce or ketchup. It will be like a thick paste of tomato, which is not sweet, but it's made of tomato paste, which is very sour. It will be different. Ketchup, chili sauce, all of it won't be like sweet and won't be appetizing to the palate of a human being. When I was making the egg, before I scrambled the egg, the egg yolk. I put a bit of water, of course, a bit only, not much. That one will help the egg, the liquid egg, to have more volume, and therefore you spread the egg out more, and also it gives it a puffiness to the egg. So that's the secret of Chinese cooking. Put some water into your egg and stir it around very quickly, so the water will be dispersed among the slime of the egg, and it will come out puffier, and the fried egg seems to have more volume. When it comes to like making egg, I prefer to use, I mean, especially scrambled egg or something like scrambled egg. This is like mixed up already, the egg is all mushy. I prefer to use a sprinkle of salt around the egg. You want to taste some egg and suddenly you have a hint of saltiness, and that makes it nicer. I do not know why. But theoretically, if you use a light soy sauce which is salty, that should taste better than just using normal salt, because soy sauce has that umami taste to in it, the MSG or the proteins that gives it a nice lovely taste. Something like sugar, the protein that's responsible for the umaminess of food. It's almost similar to like sugar. It actually tells you, ooh, it's nice, we need it more. This is nice. I must say it's quite nice. Look at this. Why is an egg? I love the egg, it's puffy, very creamy because of the water. It's not all just hard protein. Between the protein inside the egg, there's some pockets of air and water. Makes it creamy, delicious. Unfortunately, some of the caramelized onions were burnt in the process because it's already cooked. So, introducing it into a wok full of oil and heat will burn it. So there's a sweet hint of bitterness to it. When you have the yin yang of food, which makes it nicer, like salty and sweet. Bitter is not that nice actually. Bitter, it's better not to have the bitter taste to your food. Of course, the bitter stuff is like good for health. Apparently, the bitter gourd seems to like make people live longer in the islands of Okinawa in Japan. And medicine is naturally bitter. Normally the rice that's inside the fridge will be given to the chickens. So I'm commandeer and eat it for myself, right? Because my parents are out looking for medicine. I mean, going to get medicine in the hospital. That's one of the realities of life. Once you get old, hopefully I won't get old. Hopefully I'll die before I'm 40. Because once you like reach around 35 years old, your body starts to deteriorate. I mean, it's already deteriorating after like when you reach your peak, which is I think around 25 years old. Yeah, you'll be like going downhill. Your body, it'll be harder for your body to digest your food. All your food will turn into fat, and it's a lot of issues with all these things. then you would love to go to the hospital and complain to the doctor about this ailment and that ailment. That's the realities and the burden of being older, getting older. So it's quite a successful cook, quite a successful product or food that I made. I'm not a cook, I'm not a chef. I'm just somebody who enjoys looking at other people cook. Kinda. You know, Stephen Chow is a celebrity from Hong Kong who makes very funny movies back in the 1990s and 2000s. He had a show called God of Cookery or something like that. I think it's God of Cookery. There's only one wisdom that I got from that movie. That is, if you were to make fried rice, make sure your rice is old rice. Yeah, you don't need to like cook a new rice just for the day, just to make fried rice. That's stupid. That's right. It's like counterproductive. What other things that's counterproductive? I can give you an example right now. I'm eating. The best fried rice is made with old rice, which was left over from yesterday. The rice from yesterday might have been left out in the open for it to dry, become drier. Or can be put in the fridge, and the drying process is much faster because in the fridge it like takes out the moisture and I think makes it cooler. So when the rice is drier, once you reintroduce the rice into the wok and you put in all the sauces like the slight soy sauce, everything, anything like the chicken stock and whatnot, the rice, since it's dehydrated, it will suck up all the moisture, all the sauces, to make the rice even yummier and fluffier. Fluffier, not so, but tastier, because it needs the water. So it sucks up any water that you introduce into the wok. That's why you use old rice, not new, fluffy, out of the rice cooker. Because once the rice is out of the rice cooker, it's fluffy, it's full of water, it won't suck up much of the sauces. And if you take the newly cooked rice and you put it in the wok and try to make fried rice, you have to dry the rice first, and it's counterproductive, you're wasting more energy. So if you want to make fried rice as a business, make sure you make a lot of rice the day before, so it will be dry to come today and it's perfect for making fried rice. I hope that sounds logical. That's it. Today I might actually go and film the spooky looking Bangsa Village abandoned eatery. And hopefully I won't get killed by a car. And maybe today I will buy a stick of cigarette to remind myself that it is very disgusting, the stick of cigarette that is, and it might be the first time that I'll be riding a bicycle while holding a camera. Ooh, how exciting. And maybe I'll go to the cemetery and actually film the cemetery, Christian one. That's me. That's how I roll.